Hey guys, welcome to a new video. So today, as you can see by the title, James Charles isn't having the greatest time, is he? He's got himself into a bit of bother. I say a bit of bother. It's enough bother to get him to lose hundreds of thousands of subscribers. It wouldn't surprise me if he's broke a record for the most subscribers lost. And to be honest, by the sounds of things, rightly so. I was on FaceTime to my girlfriend earlier, and she told me about the whole James Charles thing. And I'd seen it on Drama Alert, but I hadn't yet watched the video. And it made me want to watch that Drama Alert, because by the sounds of things, this is a madness. So this YouTuber called Tati, I'm assuming that's how you pronounce it, she's a makeup YouTuber, and she uploaded a video called Bye Sister. It's got over 10 million views at the time of recording. It's a 43-minute video where she exposes the shit out of James Charles. And it's a madness. I've not watched it all because I don't have time for that shit, so I'm just going to skip through it and get to the good bits. And because of this video, he's been losing all those subscribers. And he made an apology video, and it's just a load of bollocks. It's like the wankiest apology video I've ever seen in my life. It's nearly as bad as Logan Paul's one after the whole Suicide Forest thing. But Tati's video starts with her just showing how much she's helped James Charles. And I didn't know this, but apparently if it wasn't for her, he might not be where he is today.
James is here to do my bridal makeup, which is what I am wearing right now. I just wanted to congratulate you on almost a million on Instagram. I want to say huge congratulations to James Charles. If you have not checked his channel out on YouTube and you want to be inspired, he's a freaking teenager and he's like a genius with makeup.
James Charles is the face of their holiday collection, and I saw him do a really cool look and it just made me want to try this palette. We are going to be taking a first look at the new Morphe palette. Hello.
I'm so scared.
Oh my gosh! Thank you. Like it?
It looks so gorgeous. Do you like it?
I love it.
Sorry, James. I'm on to another Morphe palette, but you guys can still use code James for 10% off this one.
I'm the friend that's encouraging you guys to use code James for 10% off of saving. You can use anybody's code. Use, you know, James's code. I'm wearing my sister's apparel.
That was 56 seconds worth of footage from multiple different videos where she's giving him a shout out. She's even had him in her videos before. And you know, she's a big YouTuber. She's got over 5 million subscribers. So it's clear that she helped him a lot. But let's keep going. All right, so she goes on about how she posted an Instagram story about it all and that went viral. And then says this.
What I said in that video basically was that I feel really lost in this community, and that's so true. And it is more than one thing. And it wasn't specifically just about vitamins or about Halo, but it was just about being lied to.
So she mentions vitamins. Basically, she's trying to build a vitamin brand. And James Charles apparently promoted a different vitamin brand that was a rival to the one that she's creating. And obviously with them being friends, that's kind of a dickish thing to do, isn't it? So there were a bit of beef and a bit of tension there.
And feeling disrespected. And, you know, James Charles, he had 9 days after Coachella to talk to me. He knows where I live. It's not far from him. He could have come face to face and chatted with me because he knew that this would hurt me. We've had plenty of in-person conversations that were at length about other influencers doing the same deal and him not liking Sugar Bear hair and dragging the other people and being like, Tati, I'm on your side. Like, you've got me. Like, I will support you. Yes, mom. Like, you've got my loyalty.
So basically, what I got from that is James Charles is a bit of a hypocrite. He was slating other people for doing similar things and then did it himself.
So I always felt really comfortable with that. And I, of course, to not even get a phone call, to not even get a text a few days prior, but right after that sponsored post went up, to have a text like, hey mom, love you, I'm stressed. Just so you know, XYZ, I just did this post, but it's no big. And that's pretty typical of James Charles's behavior from the time that I met him when he was 17, before he really had taken off on YouTube at all. I know that he has a way of just getting what he wants.
So James Charles is a manipulator and he tries to beat around the bush. He did it knowing that it'll probably affect her, but just did it anyway because money in it.
Obviously, so many of you guys understand that this is more than just a sponsored post. It has layers. There's so much going on with James Charles right now that I do not support, that I do not agree with. Fame, power, and a fat bank account will change almost anyone. And if you don't have people that will tell you to your face that you're doing the wrong things, you will change.
I mean, to be fair, yeah, she's not exactly wrong. Like, if you start to get money and you start to get fame, you're gonna grow an ego, aren't you? And then you're gonna want more. The whole thing about the vitamins, obviously he'll have got paid for that because it's a sponsorship. So in that moment, that's what he'll have been thinking of. He'll have been thinking of the money and not necessarily about what it could do to the people that are around him.
I think it's important for you guys to know a little bit of the history that I have with James Charles. He contacted me through my DMs, you know, when he was first starting out. He was 17. He was wide-eyed and ready to make it on Instagram and social media. And, you know, he kind of had his YouTube channel going, but not really. And, you know, the first response I gave him was like, keep up the good work or something like that. And then he came back and he just has a way of saying the most gorgeous things that make you feel so special. So he always told me that I was the reason that he wanted to get into makeup, and I was the reason that he was inspired to start his channel, and that my channel was one of his favorites and he just loved watching me. And it was just nice to hear, to be honest. I was like, wow, like this kid, like really, like I'm like the grown-up inspiration, like this, cool, like how can I help you?
So yeah, she felt flattered that he liked her channel and that he saw her as an inspiration. So she was like, oh, I'll help you then. Well, didn't that go so wrong?
Come on my channel, do my makeup. You know, we started talking pre-CoverGirl, so we're talking before everything exploded. And I had his back then. I invited him to my wedding. He didn't have money for the flight or hotel, so I paid for that happily.
Like, that's sad. She really wanted him there. Like, he was broke, he couldn't afford to come. And she paid for him because she wanted him there and she wanted to involve him. Like, a wedding's something they only do once. So, like, that's a special thing. It just seems like he's took all that for granted.
And he felt a little bit bad about it. And I was like, hey, like, let's just have fun and you can do my makeup for my wedding and help me out. It's sad to think that I will never be able to watch my wedding video without seeing his face and thinking of him.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, anybody wants to look back on their wedding and be like, that was one of the best days of my life. And she now can't do that because she'll just be thinking of what he's done.
I wrapped as much love as I could around this kid, more from like a parental stance than like a best friend stance. You know, my husband, who he ran an agency, he was the VP of motion pictures. He knows the industry through and through. I don't talk about that end of my husband's career too often. He's so gifted with his view of how deals, contracts, business development, he's a master at it, and I love his brilliant mind. He was mentored by Roland Perkins, who was one of the original founders of CAA. He has built businesses and sold them. He is so insanely intelligent. Anytime that James would need help, he'd be like, Dad, what should I do? And he'd come over and he'd be like, I don't like my manager. Will you manage me? And James is like, no, I'm not doing that. I don't do that anymore. But your family, how can I help you? My husband would spend hours on the phone, looking over contracts, getting him in a better position.
By the sounds of things, it really does seem like if it wasn't for her and a husband, I mean, obviously her husband's got him all these deals, as she's the one who showcased his talent, he would not be anywhere near where he is today. Those $500 VIP tickets, say goodbye, they're not happening.
Everything is over-sexualized, and that's the huge underlayer to this all that I finally have had enough. The last phone conversation that James Charles and I had, he said some things telling me about a situation that happened in Seattle at my birthday, and it literally made me want to vomit. Oh my God, you tried to trick a straight man into thinking he's gay yet again, and somehow you're the victim. You know, it's really disgusting to manipulate someone's sexuality, especially when they are still, you know, emerging into adulthood and don't quite have everything figured out. You are using your fame, your power, your money to play with people's emotions. You're threatening to ruin them. You're threatening to embarrass them. And you're doing that to have them behave sexually in your favor, even if they're straight. And you know what? That's not okay. That behavior's not okay. Whether you're a woman, a man, gay, straight, bi, whatever sexual orientation you are, that is your personal call and it is not someone else's to take. It's not someone else's to play with. It's not someone else's to mess with.
I think the whole thing about stabbing her in the back and this are the two main reasons that he's losing all these followers. He tried to get a straight bloke to have sex with him, and he was using all his followers, all his money and all his fame to get him to do these things to him. And that's just disgusting. You shouldn't be able to force someone to do something when that's not who they are, just because you have all the power and they don't. And apparently this has happened multiple times, because apparently he has a thing for straight blokes trying to turn him gay, which is a very weird thing.
And how dare you laugh about it and make meme after meme and retweet and this and that, and I love straight boys, and make it a joke. Because this behavior is not normal, it's not okay. Cracking someone's sexuality is not an escape room. This is shit that will follow them for the rest of their lives. And you need someone to tell you to stop it. And that's exactly what I did in your kitchen in front of Gabriel Zamora. So I'm really shocked, Gabriel, that you really don't care about this at all and what is happening. You are totally complicit with the situation, obviously, with the video that you made. All right, I'm pissed. I literally, eye to eye, had enough respect for you and love for you and care for you to tell you to go and get some help. I told you that this was not good and that you could have your career completely destroyed.
Well, I think he's done that at this point, doesn't he? I don't see any coming back from this, fuck me. Like even Keemstar said it, James Charles could be over. It is a possibility because he's losing so many followers so fast. He's just gonna keep going. Right, I'm gonna move on to his apology. I just wanna show you what he says about it and the way he's saying it. Because as I said in the start, it's fake as fuck.
Hi all, James here. I'm currently traveling abroad and just woke up, but I wanted to sit down and make a video addressing everything that's going on right now, because I owe everybody an explanation, but most importantly, I owe two important people an apology.
You see what I mean? I'm not the only one who thinks this, and it just seems fake. The pauses in between speaking, making out that it's hard to get the words out. It's just like every YouTube apology ever. There's been so many bad ones, like it's not something that YouTubers can do, is it?
To Tati and James Westbrook, I'm sorry for everything that is going on and everything that I've put you through over the past few weeks. I met Tati and James almost 3 years ago now, when I was first coming into the industry and when I had no friends and nobody to talk to or look up to. And Tati very quickly took on a parental role with me.
Yeah, that's the thing, like you're saying in the video, it wasn't a friendship, but it was more like she was his parent. He called her mum and her husband dad. Like, it was a parental role. And if you're looking at someone like their family, stabbing them in the back makes it look even worse.
And throughout all of this, what sucks the most is that I know there's nothing I can say or do to ever earn that friendship or trust back.
Well, at least he knows that much, because you've booked it now, aren't you?
In regards to the boy situation, boys have been a topic that I've talked a lot about on my social media journey, and it's a topic that I wish I hadn't. I've been involved with a lot of very unique and strange situations that have left people confused or upset. And I've learned the hard way about ways that I can interact with boys that I'm interested in.
No, but that's the thing. You're interested in them. They're not interested in you. That's not how they swing. Do you know what I mean?
And also ones that I should or shouldn't be talking to. This is a conversation that I know a lot of people are uncomfortable with, and it's something that I should have been far more careful with bringing into the public eye, especially with the last situation that just happened. I've had to learn it the hard way, but coincidentally enough, Tati really was one of the people to sit me down and tell me how it looked from the outside, and let me know, hey, talking to these boys might get you in trouble one day.
Well, she were bloody right, weren't she? But anyway, I'm going to end the video there. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, leave a like, subscribe, or leave a comment, because why not? Don't forget to turn my post notifications on so you never miss a new video and you get notified every time I upload. There's a link to my merch, my Instagram, and my Twitter in the description, so go and follow me on them. And yeah, I'll see you guys later.